Welcome. Jeff Harding here with Live Free with EFT.com. I'm here to talk about the bowl of light. You see, the ancient Hawaiians, what they used to do is they used to carve a wooden bowl for all the children when they were just born. And that bowl represented the bowl of light, their spirit, their inner resources and whatnot, because they felt that as spirits, they come here to Earth, or we come here to Earth, to have a human experience. And that bowl of light represents the light that comes through. And that's what we see here with this bowl of light, is the light shining through, and that's our inner resource, that's our spirit, that's, if you want to call it the universe, God, whatnot, that comes through. It's that inner resource that gives us the ability to be an entrepreneur, to play music, to sing, to dance, to just be goofy, whatever it is that you want to do out there. This is the light that allows you to do that. Now, this light is always there for us, constantly. Wayne Dyer once said this. He said that we always have a connection to that inner resource. It's just that it gets corroded sometimes. Well, the Hawaiians look at that as this bowl of light is always shining brightly and very, very brightly, very warmly. It can do anything. It allows the love to come through. It gives us comfort. It gives us resources. It gives us answers. It gives us inspirations. It basically tells us what we need to do in the areas that we desire, that are toward our purpose and what we ought to do. The problem is, though, sometimes we lose our pono. In other words, pono being righteousness, or our purpose and whatnot. And how that happens is pohaku, which is a stone or a rock, just like this one here from the island of Hawaii, gets in the way. And what happens is our bowl begins to fill up with pohakus, or stones or rocks. And these rocks begin to dim the light, as you can see here right now. And what these stones represent are the things in life that take away that light. That could be something as drastic as being abused physically, emotionally, mentally. Maybe it's just, as a five-year-old, somebody pushed me on the playground. And that becomes on the writings on our wall, a stone, a barrier, because it can affect us. Now, just because we're pushed doesn't necessarily mean it becomes a stone for us. But it can be quite often. It can be as innocuous as someone looking at us and saying, "Nah, I don't think you can do that." And if we're told that often enough, our light begins to be blocked, and we begin to not believe in ourselves and have that light make a difference in our lives. And what happens is, maybe in high school we get rejected by somebody that we're expressing our affection toward. Maybe a teacher tells us that we're just not smart enough and we shouldn't do that. Maybe our parents, for our own good, tell us, "No, that's too risky. Do something else that's safer." And that becomes a stone as well. And as you can see, things begin to become a little darker and darker and darker as this bowl, our bowl of light, fills up with these pohaku, or stones. What we need to do now, what the ancient Hawaiians did was they called it huli. And what they would do is turn that bowl over and dump out all the stones. Well, what we can do is we can begin to look at these stones with something we call emotional freedom technique. And what these techniques are, they're ways of taking the stones and tossing them away so that they no longer block our light. How we do that, one of the ways that we do that with EFT is through your personal peace. And that's a way that we utilize EFT to clear out these stones, remove these stones from life, so that our light can shine once again as brightly as it was when we were first born. And that's what we can do with EFT, is enter and utilize this tool in our life and allow it to enter into our life so that we can remove those stones, that brightness can shine, and then we can hear the inspiration come through to tell us what we need to do in the areas of our purpose and the things that we were made to do, what we ought to do in life. So we can experience more joy, more peace, more love, more acceptance, more forgiveness. So my recommendation to you is to do your own personal peace utilizing EFT. So stay tuned for more details on how you can do that here with EFT. And with my help, I'll be more than happy to help you through that process so that you too, again, like I said, can see your light shine through. This is Jeff Harding with LiveFreeWithEFT.com, wishing you a bright light in your present and forever in your future. Take care and keep on tapping.